and she will help you.
Such a great training environment for women, but there aren't a lot of women. So, you know, when I'm training against guys that are 200 pounds, you know, I do fine, but then I come here and I'm like, oh, that sweep really does work. It's just that I've been trying it on giant guys, you know? So it is good. It's great to try, actually test my jiu-jitsu with people my size.
Yeah, there's still, there'll be a couple more, right, by the end, by the time we get to Saturday. But we're gonna lose Melissa and someone else. Maybe not. Oh no, Jody's coming. Jody or Lee. Because she's just coming Saturday, Sunday. Darian's coming. Rachel Moore is coming. Those are great.
It's going to be more stacked than it was last time.
Yeah, maybe. I mean, I think right around 30 is where we always tend to tap out.
Basically, we just learned a great dance sequence, so I have to write it all down so that when I get home, I have all the details. I can go
like
back
me,
and drill
like,
it.
Like you'll forget it all and be like, I think there was a blast.
Yeah, exactly. So, a little mini details, the pressure details, and we're in a good place when I get back.
Squeeze your knees, sit, okay? And then, close the seat, squeeze, fall to the seat. Thank you.
I've been documenting these women's jiu-jitsu camps for the last few years. At first, I thought it would be just another video job, but it's become more than that for me. I've come away with a better sense of jiu-jitsu technique in a whole and the community behind it. I've learned more about these extraordinary women and their struggles and experiences pursuing the passion for this martial art form. What drew me to jiu-jitsu at first was that sense of community 7 years ago. And every time I have a chance to document these women in these camps, I'm reassured of that community within our sport. There are no flags, just no ego. It's just friends on the mat, learning from each other and sharing experiences.
Ambush!